Yo, what's up guys? Just before we get into the video, I just want to quickly say that there might be times in the video where you sort of can see that the quality changes or something like that, but basically what's happened is when I was recording this, there was some stuff mess up with the recording. Like, it started buffering, it started lagging a bit. I don't know what happened. Maybe there was a lot of shit going on my computer. But you might notice a quality change, but I had to kind of save clips on my PS4 and work around it. So I hope you guys can, you know, look past that. It's not that, it, you know, it's not much of a quality difference. So, but yeah, guys, I hope you enjoy the video. Okay, so yo, what's up, guys? My name's BearTheBoff, or Bear, whatever you're going to call me. And in today's video, we're going to be carrying on with the One Life. Now, we've came to the boss that has taken me out the past two times, and he's really starting to get on my tits because he's just annoying. He's a boss that literally, for some reason, he always lets me get him really low. And then when he's really low, he's like, fuck you. And he just kills me. So, yeah. We're starting over here where we killed Hyperius. And we'll make our way over there. Hopefully we don't die on the way there. Because that'll just fucking... That'll just straight away just kill the mood. You know what I mean? It'll just kill me. What I want to do then, though, is not risk dying. So, you know. Probably kill these or just not jump right into them. But yeah, guys, this boss is just, he's fucking annoying me now. He's just to the point now where it's just, like, it's, instead of it being just a one-life run, it's beat Guy. Instead of the target being, you know, one-life boss run, it's just get past Guy. that's what the target is now, because it's just got to the point where I just can't get past him. Like I say, he's just really annoying because he's not a very hard boss. He's random, and this super bass loader really wants to try and just don't do it. Just don't even try it. I hate these because these super bass loaders can just shit on you. If you're left with an elemental effect, they just crap on you. So yeah, like I was saying, it's just annoying now because it's like it's just trying to beat Guy and he's just random. Like, he'll just decide when he wants to kill you, and that's it. Like, him and his fucking minion worms will just be like, this is the time where we're gonna, you know, do like a formation attack against you, and fucking, he like shoots one of his rockets, throws like that tomahawk, and you get like spit on by that green acid from the worms. So it's just, you know, it's just AIDS. I've practiced him a little bit before recording this, and I got him really close twice, and I know I can do it. I know I can beat him. I know I can beat him. It's just, I just gotta be on point. And also, I'm just gonna say, like, pre-warn, if I'm like really quiet, I'm gonna try and not talk too much while, because like, well, not try and not talk, but try and, like, you know, focus, because I do want to get past him, because it would be more fun as well to get onto later bosses. Okay. I pop guns out then just to regain that health, because if I'd have killed him and then died, oh my god, I would have been fuming. I would have been would have raged bad. But yeah, it would be fun to get past, and I think if I do get past him, I think the next boss would be Dexidius, if I'm right in saying that. But if I do Dexidius and beat him, I think Veracidus would be next. But what I'm thinking is, I'm thinking of leaving Veracidus to next, because Veracidus is like easily one of the hardest like bosses, probably the hardest boss. And where is it? Where are we going? Haters follow. Yeah, he's like easily one of the hardest bosses. So I think leaving him till last will be better. So I can, you know, he'll be like the final. Like the final hurdle to like overcome, because he's definitely the hardest boss, to be fair. Yeah. Yeah, boy, so I need to make sure I've got ammo. So yeah, I'll leave him till last, because if I get past Guy, and then I get beat Dexidius, and then straight away I get shit on by Veracidus, what'll happen is, that'll happen, and that'll annoy me, so I'll come back, and then I'll get killed by Guy again, and I'll get fucking stuck on Guy, and it'll just come into like a... It'll just become like a routine of just getting fucked by Guy. Luckily getting past Guy and then getting my ass handed to me by Veracidus. And then, you know, getting back to Guy and then getting my ass handed again. And just rinse and repeat. So yeah, I'll leave Veracidus till last and then we'll go through all the rest of them. But I have been dreading coming back to this cunt, because he's just, oh, this. And the thing is as well, his boss fight is like, it's a fight that you need to concentrate, but it's just boring. Like, because all it is the same shit. And if you watch my last one, you'll know how I talked about, like, my last Master Gi attempt. You'll know how I talked about Gi a lot of the time will just randomly not spawn a worm, and then out of nowhere spawn two. And both times I've just practiced Gi, he's done it. And it's just irritating. It's like, why you do this? Okay, this is where I need to be careful. What I'm going to do is I'm going to use guns, okay? Because honestly, with the rabid skags here and shit, it's not surprising to die there while you're waiting to get in. So yeah, I'll quickly go over my build. It's the same as last time, kind of, but I've made a slight change. And it's in the class mod. But starting from the top, unkempt howl, grog nozzle again. Gunzerken, you know, the standard build, but it's you know, beastie. I've got infinity, because the infinity is really good in this fight to be able to stay alive. Because it basically, if I kill a worm and then I've still gunzerking, if I hold my grog and pull my infinity out, I can constantly shoot Gi while bringing him towards the puddle. So it's like less likely for me to die. So that's with that. And also I can just shoot him here and there to gain my gunzerk back. Lady Fist, because it can clutch like mad. Like I said in the last one, and like you might have seen in my clutch video, that can clutch bad like Lady Fist can. Evolution, because it's got high capacity, it increases my health, so that's good. And the elemental resistance helps against them balls of acid that the worm shoot at you. The Quasar to bring Gi in. Like, if I'm going to try my best not to use that many Quasars, because saving them really helps. But I'll try my best, you know, to conserve them as much as I can. But if I need to use them, use Quasar to drag him into it. Sheriff's Badge being as, you know, all pistols. It's perfect. And, yeah, this is the change. Basically, before I was using Chaotic Evil Monk, but I was thinking about it just, and I was thinking about there's not actual any point to me using Chaotic Evil Monk, because I'll still be able to take the worms down as quick. So I won't need the extra damage. I can't really damage Gi. Well, you can't really damage Gi with guns. The way you kill him is, you know, getting him into the puddles. So I thought, why not give something that will actually benefit me? So this Legendary Berserker Comet's got the cooldown rate, which, you know, will help between phases of Gunzerk. Fire rate, which will help with the infinity, keep me alive even more. Melee damage, that's not really necessary. But then you've got movement speed while Gunzerking, which helps because dodge to his attacks and the worm's attacks. And then it also increases stuff like this. So like, if I do get hit, my movement speed is, instead of like 30%, it's 60%, which is a big thing. And it's just little increasements like that that help. And then, like, where is it? Here, weapon swap speed. That might clutch out for me if I need to swap to the grog quick and pop a grenade and get health back. So, yeah, that's why I've gone with that comp. So, yeah, that's my build, guys. There's my skill tree. Same as last time, but for our show anyway. So, yeah, let's get into... Oh, yeah, I'm still gunzerking. I'll wait for this to sort of run out a bit. Because I don't want to get into the fight and get to the point where I'm like, need to gunzerk and it's cooldown. So I'll wait for this to run out a bit, and then we'll use my infinity. Use my infinity in a sec, and then I'll just keep clipping him, and that should regen my cooldown. So yeah. About that, I'll be alright. I'm hoping his gun is like an okay one. He hasn't shot it yet, so I can't really tell. Please don't be the fast shooting and fast fire, like, fire rate. Yeah, see, that increasement in move speed's big. Okay, so let's take this one. See, I really don't need the Chaotic Evil Monk for the damage. I mean, I can do enough damage. Got this. Okay, so that's there. The good thing about that as well is when I'm in there shooting him, trying to get him to absorb that, most of the time I'll get hit, so that'll help with escaping as well. But But there's times like this where my gun zerk's nearly out. Like that. It's a bit awkward. I think he absorbed that. It's awkward with that when my gun zerk's like kind of running out because there's not a lot I can do in that situation. So a lot of times you'll see me like not kill a worm so I can wait for my gun zerk to run out and rebuild it and then kill it. Because a lot of time if it runs out it can fuck you up. Luckily, he hasn't got fast bullet speed, which is really good. Because the fast bullet speed can really fuck you up. Okay, we need to get around here. Okay, we're back, guys. Oh, shit. Oh, my God. One sec, I need to stop. Okay. Sorry about that, guys. Basically, I'm on Elgato. I could hear my game lagging, so I didn't want the gameplay to be really buffery and stuff. I don't know what's... Hopefully, it's not messed up. I've saved, like, the gameplay on my console, so, you know, if anything mess up, I should be alright. But, so, it's just stuff like that happens. You can't help it. It just happens sometimes. So, it looks alright now, so we'll carry on with it, and I'll figure it afterwards, so. And the thing is, I need to figure out how I'm going to get out of this. Okay, go. So yeah, I forget what I was saying before because sorting that out, but either way. Let's just do this. Yeah, it's the only real annoying thing about recording is like when you go to record something and something messes up, it just, oh, can be such a downer on you, but where will it get to me? It's alright. So we've got his shield down practically now. That's good. This legendary berserker comm is helping out so much with this movement speed. That movement speed is amazing. And then the fire rate on my infinity, that's helping a lot as well, being able to heal. What I can do now is also shoot him to regain my gunzerk back while I'm gunzerking. But yeah, that movement speed is really, really helping it, being able to just get out of the situation I'm in. Right, so I'm not going to say anything about how the fight's going because I don't want to jinx it. But at the minute, we're doing okay. Oh shit. I got a bit control of the tide there. Okay, get out of that. Okay, I haven't had to use any grenades yet either, which is good. Corroded me, that's annoying. Come over here, gate. Absorb it. There we go. It's annoying as well. Like, look how long. What the fuck? Okay, come on. I was just about to say, look how long, like, the drunk effect is lasting on the infinity. Guys, it's bullshit sometimes. Sometimes it lasts a long time, and it's harder to heal off that then. What I'm going to need to start doing is, whenever that happens, just change to my unkempt, because in that situation, the unkempt is, you know, it's not a problem. But the infinity, when being drunk, it's can be a big harm to you. Because you can't really get consistent shots off, so you can't heal properly, and it can just fuck you up. Okay. Okay, I'm not going to kill that worm yet. I'm going to kind of save it up. Try and get my guns out back a bit. Like I say, I don't wanna kill it, run out of gunzerk and not be able to heal properly while getting gi into it. And it just caused me to die and then a worm doesn't spawn and well that's me dead. Okay, so it's caused another worm to spawn, but that's okay because I've still got a lot of gunzerk left, so. Oh, okay. There we go. So that was a good switch. It's annoying because you've probably heard me say in my last videos I did, or my last gi, you know, one life, but he moves quick. For a guy that looks like he moves so slow, he moves like an absolute fucking Sonic. Okay. Okay, absorb that. I'm spamming L3 so much. Oh shit. Okay, I should have enough time. I'm not gonna risk it. I'm not gonna risk it. Get my gun zerk back. Yeah, I'm not gonna risk killing it and run out. Good thing about this though is I sort of delay this worm for the second spawn. So it means that I can kind of have two worms at once. I can get the game. So like now the worm spawned and I've still got all my guns up because of me waiting then. Okay, so he's not coming over right now, so I'm going to have to pull him. Oh, yes, okay, he got that. Run. It's annoying because it's like I want to get hit sort of so I can get mod speed. But I don't want to get hit because it just means I'm close to dying. Okay, let's get my guns out back. Oh, shit. Okay, it's alright. So this, like, look, he's tailing me behind so close, even though I'm, like, sprinting. Okay, I'm going to try and not use a quasar here. That's nicely timed. Ooh, you fucker. It's these tomahawks mainly that are annoying. Because they, for some reason, are like fast as fuck boy. And they track you like mad. Like, they just fully track you. They just, like, full on track you. Like, it's because you'd think, yeah, like him throwing one as you're moving, it'd miss you because he throws it straight. But that's just not the way it works. Ooh, okay. Okay, so we've got this shield out now. Okay. Keep him there. Okay, he's absorbed that one. Oh shit, I nearly ran back into that one. Okay, we got another worm up. Oh, my gun's nearly out. Nope. Good job I caught that. But it's like here where the worm can sort of shoot one and he can throw that at the same time like that. And it can fully kill me. So that's gone. Ooh, I'm going to drag him back into there. That's what I saved the quasars for. It's annoying because when I go into that drunk phase, the infinity just, with how helpful it can be, it's not as helpful anymore. Okay. Okay, calm. Let's be calm about this. Let's not. I haven't won yet. Okay. No, you bastard. No, you don't. No, you fucking don't. Okay, let's just be calm about it. It's Gunzerk. Okay. Yes! Let's fucking... Oh my god, you don't realise how good that feels. Yes! Woo! Let's fucking go. Oh my god, I sound like such a COD boy, but I don't care. Yes! Oh my god. Literally, just switching to that changed this fight so fucking much. Oh, we Yes, guys, letter. Yes. We finally got Basky. Oh, fuck this cunt. Fuck this cunt. Oh, yes, that felt good. Oh, that felt good. Let's, do you know, I need to go and just give him a quick tea bag. Oh, let's just get it over. Oh, yes. Oh, that's so good. The Patriot, apparently not a good sniper. I haven't really used it, but fuck it, that's not what I'm bothered about. It's just, we killed this cunt. Oh, guys, I am so glad that's done. So, yeah, now that that's done, as I was saying, Dexidius is, I think Dexidius is the next one in the line of bosses. And, yeah, we'll see what happens with that. But if that goes well, Veracidus, I think I'm going to say for last. I think. So, yeah. I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. I'm so happy with that. I am so happy with that. I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. And I will catch you in the next one.